The fractional function, the function which written in the form, in the fractional form, like f of x equal 1 over x. The point of center of this function equals 0, 0. So the domain will be R except the x coordinate in this vertex, in this point of symmetry. So it will be R except 0. And the range will be R except the y coordinate in this point. That means R except 0. The monotony, the function decreases on R except 0. And the function is an odd function. Negative 1 over x, the function will reverse the or drawn on in second and fourth quad like this. The domain equal R except the x coordinate, which is 0, and the range equal R except the y coordinate, which is 0. Finally, the domain, the function increase on R except 0 or in its domain, and the function finally is an odd function. F of x equal 1 over x plus 1, that means the point of symmetry equals 0 comma 1, that means the domain equal R except 0 and the range equal R except 1. The monotony, the function decrease on its domain or decrease on R except 0, the function is and of course it's not symmetric about the y-axis or the origin, so the function it's not even nor odd. 1 over x, f of x equal 1 over x minus 2, that means the point of symmetry equals 0 comma negative 2, then the domain R except 0 and the range R except negative 2. Then the monotony, the function decrease on its domain or decrease on R except 0. Finally, it's not even or odd function. F of x equal negative 1 over x plus 2. Negative, that means the function will be drawn on second and fourth, and the point of symmetry equals 0 comma 2. The function is shifted 2 units up on the y-axis, so the domain equal R except 0 and the range R except 2. What about the monotony? The function increase on R except 0 or on its domain. The function, of course, it's not an even or odd function. F of x equal 1 over x minus 1, that means the vertex equal 1 comma 0. The point of symmetry equal 1 comma 0. The function shifted only 1 unit to the right. The domain will be R except 1, and the range would be R except 0. Of course, the function decreases on its domain or decreases on R except 1, then it's not an even or odd. F of x equal negative 1 over x plus 1 plus 2. First, the point of symmetry equal negative 1 comma 2, and the function will drawn on in second and fourth quad. Then the domain, I said that the point of symmetry equal negative 1 comma 2, so the domain R except negative 1 and the range R except 2. The function increase on its domain or on R except negative 1. It's not an even or odd function. F of x equal 1 over x plus 2 minus 2, that means the point of symmetry equal negative 2 comma negative 2. The function shifted 2 units to the left on the x-axis and 2 units down on the y-axis. Again, the point of symmetry equal negative 2 comma negative 2, that means the domain equal R except negative 2 and the range also equal R except negative 2. The function decreases on its domain, and of course it's not an even or odd function. F of x equal 2 minus 1 over x, that means the vertex or the point of symmetry equals 0 comma 2 and the function will be in second and fourth quad. So the domain equal R except 0 and the range R except 2. The function increase on its domain, and of course it's not an even or odd function. F of x equal 1 over x plus 1 plus 1, that means the point of symmetry equal negative 1 comma 1, that means The domain would be r except negative 1 and the range r except 1. Finally, the function decrease on its domain, then it's not even or odd. Here we have the another type of function, which is piecewise function. The function first defined as 1 over x1 x less than 0 and absolute x1 x greater than 0. To draw the function, first absolute x1 x greater than 0 would be a straight line like this, and 1 over x when x less greater than sorry when x less than 0 will be curved like this. What about the domain of the function? The domain will be r except 0, because 0 is open on both intervals. The range will be r except 0. The function decreased from negative infinity to 0, then increase from 0 to infinity. Of course, it's f of x equal x squared when x greater than 0 and the absolute x when x less than or equal 0. First, when x greater than 0 equal x squared, that would be part of from the parabola of x squared, and x less than or equal 0 would be a straight line like this. The domain would be r, and the range starts from 0 to infinity. The function decreased from negative infinity to 0, then increased from 0 to infinity. Of course, it's not an even or odd function. F of x equal absolute 1 over x. First, let's expand or define the absolute. It will be 1 over x when x greater than 0 and the negative 1 over x when x less than 0. How to draw 1 over x when x greater than 0? It will be curved like this. And when x less than 0, that would be part from a fractional function, and it's negative, so it will be drawn on second quad. Finally find the domain. The domain r except 0, and the range start from 0 to infinity, opened 0 to infinity. The function increase from negative infinity to 0, then decrease from 0 to infinity. Of course, it's an even function because it's symmetrical about the y-axis. F of x equal x times absolute x. Let's expand this absolute. So it will be x times x when x greater than or equal 0, and x times negative x when x less than 0 type. That means equal f of x will be x squared when x greater than 0 and negative x squared when x less than 0. That means x squared when x greater than 0 are going to graph the parabola, part from the parabola, then negative x squared, it will be then part from the parabola but reflected on the x-axis. That means will be like this. Finally, find the domain. The domain will be r, and the range also r. The function increase on r, and the function is an odd function. Write the rule of each of the following. First, determine the point of symmetry. This is a fractional function. The point of symmetry would be 3,3. So I can say that the function rule equal 1 over x minus 3 plus 3. Here I have this is a parabola, second degree, and the vertex will be 2,1. So the function will be x minus 2 or power 2 plus 1. That means the horizontal shaft equal 2 units to the right, so x minus 2, and the vertical transformation equal 1 unit, so it's plus 1. Third one, here I have this is the absolute function, and the vertex equal negative 1 comma 0, so it's shafted on the x-axis 1 unit to the left, and no vertical transformation, so the function will be x plus 1, absolute x plus 1. Finally, here I have this third degree function, and the vertex will be 0 comma negative 1. I know that this is not exactly negative 1, but this is a mistake. It's 0 comma negative 1, so the function will be x power 3, because there is no horizontal transformation, and shifted 1 unit to the left, 1 unit down. That means negative 1.